So being closer to God
exposes
the secret of man.
If
you are a person, you want to know the secret of your
neighbor,
come to my God. He will tell you all the secrets. Listen, you see the same way Samson could not hide secrets. That's also how God
is.
There is a place when you touch God,
He
will expose you all the secrets. You are behaving like you don't know God. Some of you, when you touch your wife, you gave her some gifts. She can tell you anything. She can expose you anything. Some of you, your husband, when you do some things, that man can remove any amount of money. He said, I'm taking you to Dubai and I pray, may your holiday come forth.
Receive it.
Can I hear you shout a big amen?
I receive it.
So the secret is simply one. Know where to touch someone's heart and his reactions. So there are many secrets that God is about to expose to your life. Some of you have been bypassing where your house should be. I never
knew.
Some of you have been bypassing your house. Like me. I used to bypass that place
for
a long time.
Zaman,
I never knew. This is the place God wants me to be. Some of you have been bypassing your car in the showroom, and yet God anointed the car to be yours. But you can only get it when you can swim in the secretness of God's presence. Tell your neighbor, get closer.
Get closer. Yes, sir.
Get closer.
I'm getting closer.
Some of you have seen some nation on TV. That nation, God wants you to go there. God has to reveal to you a secret. And He cannot reveal that secret until you touch like Samson was touched. You need to be a Delilah to Jesus. God, tell me all the secrets you hide. Where all your power come from? Where all your strength come from? And when you touch Jesus somehow, He's going to expose the secret of your
breakthrough.
Am I prophesying to a woman here? Am I prophesying to a man here? Let the secret of your breakthrough come today. Let the secret of your business come today.
I receive
the secret of your ministry.
I take it.
Come now.
I receive.
I say now.
I receive.
I say now.
I take it.
I say now.
I take it.
I say now.
I take it.
Receive
it. Take it.
So there is a secret that God is about to expound to you. There is a man with the name of John. The Bible says John.
Johanna,
when Jesus said, "One among you will betray me," the Bible says John did not look left and right.
Hana kuangalia.
He laid his head on the chest of Jesus. And suddenly, Jesus exposed the secret. He said, "John, the one I will give a bread is the one who will betray me." Ladies and gentlemen, the secret is not in the hand of man. The secret is in the hand of God. The secret how to win that man. The secret how to win that business. The secret how to win that house.
It's
not in the bank.
It's
not in any other place. It's in the Jesus Christ. You are wasting time by looking at men. You are wasting time by opening your phone looking for who to help. Your secret is in the hand of God. When you can discover the secret, then you receive the key.
Yes, Lord.
Secret.
Siri.
Is it Jesus?
Iko katika Yesu.
That man,
yule mtu,
cannot feed you.
Awezi akakulisha.
That woman,
yule mwanamke,
cannot take care of you.
Awezi akakusaidia.
The only man who can take care of
yule ambaye atakusaidia
is Jesus Christ.
Ni Kristo Yesu mwenyewe.
Ah, Jesus said,
Yesu akasema,
what to you? Who look unto man? Cursed are those who look unto man. And don't look unto God. So there is a place where your total dependence has to be on God. And sometimes God will create circumstances to take you into a place where you saw, you will see that man is useless. Unless God uses a man to bless you. When God can see that it is men that are your strength, He will take those men away from you. If He thinks that you think that that husband is your strength, that wife is your strength, He will make sure He take that husband away so that you can see it is not a husband, but it is me. The Bible says He's a jealous God. And when He's a jealous God, He does not share His glory with anybody. When He loves you, He wants all of you. That's why He should say, if you love me more than, if you love your husband more than me, then you don't deserve to follow me. If you love your children more than me, then you don't deserve to follow me. But if you can leave everything and follow me, then you deserve me. There is a time coming where social media shall be away from your phone. There is a time coming whereby WhatsApp shall be away from your head. There is a time coming whereby video call shall be away from you. Because you shall give your whole attention to the Lord. Listen to me, people of God. You cannot make it to the top when you spend 30 minutes on social media. Not even 1 hour, but 30 minutes on social media. You cannot make it to the top because those things takes away your attention. As much as good, you come, you can get out. But when you stay for too long on social media, it takes away your attention. Okay. I was checking a documentary yesterday. And the documentary, it was a billionaire documentary. And there was a man who is going to be the first trillionaire in the world.
Atakuwa trillionaire wa kwanza duniani.
So we are moving from billion to trillion.
Natoka katika bilioni kwa
not a company, a man, one man.
Sio kampuni, mtu mmoja.
Why? Because he's building an aeroplane
maana anajenga
that will be accessing the moon.
Ambayo itaingia katika mwezi.
Aeroplane.
Tiara ama ndege.
So when you access the moon,
ukiingia mwezi,
there is a place to sleep.
Kuna mahali unalala.
And per day,
na siku moja,
you are paying almost to $2 million.
Unalipa
one night to sleep in that moon, one room like this.
Usiku moja tu.
In the moon,
katika mwezi,
you are paying almost $2 million.
Unalipa
and the ticket is how much? $1 million.
Na tiketi ni milioni dola elfu mia moja. Milioni moja.
So what he has planned,
kile amepanga,
is going to make him the first trillionaire in the world. You're looking at me like your people are not going to receive breakthrough. Can you receive breakthrough?
Unaniangalia ni kama pesa zimekukataa.
Trillionaire in dollars.
Trillionaire katika dollar.
I'm not talking about shillings.
Siongei kuhusu shilingi za Kenya. Dollar.
And this guy is an Indian.
Na huyu jamaa ni Mhindi.
Who worship idols.
Ambaye anaabudu buta.
But when I listen to him,
lipo msikiza,
he said to me principle that I found in the Bible.
Akanipa wosia nikapata ndani ya Biblia pole.
What is it?
Nini hiyo?
He talked about some principles
aliniambia kuhusu wosia,
which are biblical.
Ambao ni za kibiblia.
But
lakini,
worshiping idols.
Anaabudu masanamu.
God is obligated to bless you.
Mungu atakubariki
as long as you are doing the principle of prosperity.
Kama unafuata wosia wa kufanikiwa. I hear you, sir.
A lot of people where they are Christian today, they don't have it because they are not practicing the principle of prosperity.
Wakristo wengi maskini wa haya maana ana wosia.
He said one thing which is very powerful. He said,
akasema,
many people don't understand.
Watu wengi hawaelewi.
Being rich is not having a lot of money.
Sio kuwa na pesa.
Being rich is based on how many lives you impacted.
Ni kwa vile utaguza maisha watu wengi.
These are the things we teach here.
Ibasi ndio mambo tunaguza hapa.
If you can impact one life,
kama unaweza guza maisha moja,
that is $1.
Basi hiyo ni dola moja.
If you impact 3 people,
guza watatu,
that is $3.
Hizo ni dola tatu.
If you can impact 10 people,
kipata kumi,
that is $10.
Hiyo ni dola kumi.
Jesus. How many lives do you impact as a Christian?
Umeguza maisha watu wangapi?
Look at how the devil play with you.
Angalia vile shetani anakuchezea.
Gossip that one. Hate that one.
Chukia ule.
Jealous that one.
Ule akona wivu.
It's that one.
Piga ule.
You don't know that the devil is playing with you.
Ujia kwamba
so that you cannot
kuchezea
impact anybody.
Usikaguse maisha mtu yeyote.
And you remain broke.
Na unabaki bila kitu.
And then number two he said.
Ya pili akasema.
He said, You got to be humble. He said, if there is any side even of exhibition of pride or arrogance in you, he said, you can never make it.
He said,
these things is in the Bible. Humility, I give more grace to the humble. I give more grace to the humble. So as long as you are humble, I will lift you. Yes. How many people just because of they start paying you 100,000 shillings, you start feeling big head? Your business starts giving you like let's say maybe 200,000 shillings. Or you are paid and you have some 2 houses and you begin to feel 2 heads. And yet God has a great destiny ahead of your life. Big cars does not make you rich. But how many lives have you impacted? How humble are you?
Wewe ni mnyenyekevu namna gani?
How humble are you?
Ni mnyenyekevu namna gani?
And then I saw another one.
Alafu nikaona kitu
kingine. He said,
akasema,
there is a great world.
Kuna dunia.
This is the one which surprised me. He said there is a great world.
Kuna dunia kuu.
He said that world is not in the outside.
Ile dunia iko
nje. But that world is in the inside.
Dunia iko ndani.
This one,
I dunia,
is a man who is building robots.
Ni mtu ambaye anajenga robots.
And it's going to also make him among the trillionaire company.
Na pia zitafanya awe trillionaire mkubwa.
He's preparing people to 2045.
Anaandaa watu kwa 2025.
The world is moving to a place from being human being into robots.
Dunia inatoka kwa wanadamu iwe machine.
You can sit in Dubai, it has started.
Dubai imeanza.
But this man is the one who came with it.
Uyu ndiye alikuja nayo. Tazama.
This man says something very crazy.
Akasema kitu cha kushangaza.
He says the world is more spiritual than physical.
Dunia ni ya kiroho kuliko
vile. This robot I'm building here
is a robot
in a jenga. You cannot do it in the outside strength.
Hauwezi kufanya na
nguvu za spiritual strength.
Unahitaji nguvu za kidani.
These are billionaires.
Hawa ni mabilionea.
They said, as long as your inner man is strong, in your outside you can do anything. Paul prayed for us. I pray for you.
Paulo akasema na waombea
that you may be strengthened.
Ya kwamba mwe na nguvu.
Where?
Wapi?
In your innermost being.
Katika mtu wako wa ndani.
So that when you are strong in the inside, you can do anything. I can do all things through Christ Jesus, who strengthens me. Christians are the most powerful people who are supposed to change the world. Because we have the secrets. There are people who are working to change the world. But you are working to change your house.
Lakini wewe unabadilisha nyumba yako.
You got to focus.
Lazima ulenge.
You got to focus.
Lazima ulenge.
There is many secrets God wants to reveal.
Kuna siri mingi Bwana anatufunulia.
Which will change the world.
Ambao itabadilisha dunia.
You are the one that God has changed.
Wewe tu ndio Mungu atatoa.
For you to change your family.
Ya kwamba ubadilisha familia yako.
Your community, your city.
Mji wako.
And everything about you.
Na kila kitu kukuhusu.
100,000 is not enough for you.
Laki moja sio pesa imetosha.
$100,000 is not enough for you.
Laki moja dola sio pesa imetosha.
You don't get money for yourself, you get money to help others.
Haupati pesa ujiwekee, wapata pesa usaidiane.
Those are selfish people who say, I just want something good for my family. You are too selfish.
Penda wanasema wanataka vitu vya kwao.
God does not bless just individual. He bless individual so that individual can be a blessing to others.
Mungu anabariki watu ili kwamba wawe baraka kwa wengine.
And the reason those people are getting blessed because they are a blessing.
Wanabarikiwa kwa sababu wao ni baraka.
They are blessings.
Wao ni baraka.
Let love bring you closer to your destiny.
Wacha uruhusu hatima yako ikukaribie.
Enter that house of you today.
Ingia nyumba yako leo.
Look at the people around.
Tazama wale waliokuzunguka.
And say from today.
Useme kutoka leo.
The closest person of my life.
Yule ambaye atakuwa karibu.
Will not be my chair.
Hatakuwa.
Will not be social media.
Hatakuwa mtandao.
Will not be anybody.
Hatakuwa mtu yoyote.
If it's not an encounter with my God.
Kama sitakuwa mtu wa kuguzana na Mungu.
Are you getting this?
Yes, sir.
Are you getting this?
Yes, sir.
I need you in the next 4 months coming
Man,
before the end of this.
Miezi ijayo.
God to give you a secret that will change your financial
Bwana
life.
Atakupa siri tabadilisha hatima ya kifedha.
And that can only happen when you enter into a closest time.
Na itatendeka wakati utaingia mahali.
For your next level.
Kwa sababu ya kiwango chako kijao.
I will tell you a secret how I develop my dimensions.
Mbia siri ambao vile naendelea kupaa.
In the Lord.
Katika Bwana.
And I'm not, I will tell you.
Na nitakwambia.
When I want God to do something new in my life,
nikitaka Mungu atende kitu kizuri maisha yangu,
I don't pray too much.
Siombi sana.
It's a mistake.
Nikosa.
Wow. I,
Baba,
shut myself.
Anajifungia ndani.
And I expose myself.
Na ninajifungua.
In silence.
Katika kunyamaa.
I spoke, but you still not understand it.
Nimeongea lakini imekupita sio.
Remember,
kumbuka,
God was not in the fire when Elijah was expecting him.
Mungu hakuwa kwa moto ukija.
God was not in the shaking.
Haikuwa katika
mtetemeko
wa
ardhi. The Bible says it was a soft wind. Kulikuwa
ni sauti.
Silence.
Ikiwa imekuja imenyamaa.
And there, there was a strong voice.
Na pale kukatoka sauti.
Christian are looking for God in noisy places.
Mtu anatafuta Mungu katika
concert. God is not in a noisy place. Though himself is noisy.
Lakini Mungu hayuko katika hiyo concert.
He wants you to dwell in a secret place.
Anatamani ukae katika mahali pasiri.
Can I tell you something? Why Muslims are making it?
Wakati Uislamu anaendelea.
In the prosperity grace.
Katika
and why Hindus as well, they are making it.
Na Hindi pia wanaendelea.
They know these secrets. Watch this carefully. I'm telling you.
Tazama.
There is one secret they know.
Kuna siri moja wanajua.
Quietness.
Kunyamaza.
Which Christians don't know.
Ambao Wakristo hawajui.
They think to enter in the room is like kata, 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 all the time. Fire. Demons come out. Fire.
Mapepo toka.
But then. You never hear them casting demons. When they want to cast demons, they call their sheikh.
Wanaita sheikh.
To cast out their majini.
Aje atoe majini katika nyumba zao.
If they can't, they read their Quran.
Kama hawezi, wanasoma Quran.
And they to cast out demons.
Ili kwamba wakemee mapepo na Quran.
They don't know.
How are you?
The ability to cast demons.
Uwezo wa kukemea.
Are you Christian, you know?
Wewe Mkristo si unajua hata
umefika. But there's one thing that make them strong.
Kuna kitu moja ilifanya wae na nguvu.
Quietness.
Kunyamaa.
Silence.
Kunyama.
How can a Christian develop the ability of quietness?
Mkristo atakuwa na uwezo namna gani?
I was in a flight recently.
Baba alikuwa katika tiara.
So we enter with mama.
Tukaingia na mama katika tiara.
So we were sitting on the first row.
Waliketi katika ndege ile.
Not economy, I'm talking about first class.
Naongea kuhusu kule mbele. Ni
vizuri. Your jealousy.
Tuelewane mapema.
So when I enter,
alipoingia,
I always look at the people who sit in the first class.
Anaangalia wale wanaangalia wanaketi katika first class.
Because those people are making money.
Maana wale watu wana pesa.
They know secrets.
Wanajua siri.
Either you are in the spiritual world of darkness or in the light.
Ama wewe ni muubaji wa shetani ama Mungu, tunajuana.
We sit there.
Tunaketi pale.
There are others, they use others.
Kuna wengine
wanatumia Jesus.
Sisi tuna Yesu.
So we were in the front.
Kwa hivyo baba alikuwa kule mbele.
So my spirit, I just have to make sure I take control.
Roho yake lazima achike mamlaka.
The whole plane, I make sure.
Ndege yote hata engine kila
mahali. No spirit dominate over the plane.
Hakuna mapepo
atakao. It's not the spirit of God.
Kama sio roho wa Mungu.
So I was there.
Alikuwa pale baba.
And I looked at my right.
Akatazama huku.
Since it was a night flight.
Angalia
so people are getting ready to sleep.
Watu wanataka kulala.
I saw a guy.
Nikaona jamaa.
And this guy was like my son, the Indian.
Na jamaa alikuwa muhindi
kama Jesus.
Kama,
so this
kama
guy was an Indian.
Alikuwa muhindi.
He put his leg like this.
Akaleta miguu yake huku
on top of the chair, you know.
Nyuma kwa kiti. Na akaanza.
I'm like, "Hey, this thing is happening here."
Akazianza. Akazianza mbele yangu.
And he put his hand like this.
Na kaweka mikono yake hivi.
And his head like this.
Na kichwa chake
akaanza. And he closed his eyes.
Na akafunga macho yake
akasema, "Here it's warfare."
Akasema amesafiri. Sasa vita ikaanza.
Say warfare.
Warfare.
So I was there. Mama is there, but me I was like, I have to terminate this guy. Because as long as we are in the sky,
kama tuko hapa,
that means it's also a spiritual place.
Inamaanisha ni mahali pa kiroho.
It's also a close place where you can have an encounter.
Mahali unaweza ukaingia na ukapaa.
So in the air,
katika mji,
is worshiping.
Basi anaabudu.
And yet Christian, when they enter in the plane,
na Kristo akiingia
kwa plane, movie.
Kitu cha kwanza movie ama selfie.
And when they don't see movie, this plane is old.
Cinema, hakuna ya Jack Rambo.
You are looking for movie.
Unatafuta movie ya Jack
Rambo. And yet people are entering there and they are in encounter.
Na wengine wameweka miguu, wamesafiri jamani. Ai.
Are you seeing that?
Unaona?
He stayed like that.
Akasafiri.
In one position. For like 3 hours to 4 hours.
Kwa masaa matatu manne.
Just like that.
Yeye yako pale anaabudu.
Until he fell asleep, the same position like that.
Katika hiyo tu akiabudu
like this one.
Nikasema huyu.
And how many Christians?
Na Wakristo wa
gani? Stand in quietness even for 1 hour.
Wanaweza wakakaa katika kunyamaa lisali moja.
Their thoughts start flying rent.
Akiliza kuzipa.
Their thoughts start flying I owe debt. Their thoughts are flying, hey, I don't have money.
Na sijui sina pesa.
There is no concentration.
Hakuna kunyamaa
to Christian.
Kwa Mkristo.
That is the problem.
Hiyo basi ndio shida yetu jamani.
When you close your eyes, you see a demons of your family.
Ukifunga macho yako unaona ile uliro kabla urogo ulikuwa nani.
When you sleep, you see an uncle appearing to you.
Ukilala unasema waliniroga.
So your mind is saturated by evil oppression.
Sasa umejaa katika
usumbufu. And you can't see destiny.
Hauoni hatima yako.
So what I do,
kwa hivyo kile nakifanya,
I enter,
naingia
in the quietness dimension.
Katika kunyamaa.
Quiet dimension is the creative dimension.
Si unyamaze hiki.
What did I say? Is the what? Creative dimension.
Wiki hii uumbe ukinyamaza.
So when I enter in that quietness,
ingia katika ile kunyamaa,
I meditate.
Natafakari.
What do I meditate?
Natafakari nini?
There is a scripture that will drop in my heart.
Na andiko itaingia katika moyo wangu.
That scripture.
Lile andiko.
Is my key.
Ni funguo yangu.
To enter.
Kuingia.
And when I enter,
na nikiingia,
I will use that scripture.
Tumia lile andiko.
To create all things.
Kuumba vyote nivitakavyo. Jesus.
For example, the Bible says in Matthew
chapter 10, maandiko inasema,
I give you authority.
Nakupatia mamlaka.
Right? Authority over evil spirits.
Mamlaka juu ya mapepo yote.
Raise the dead.
Inua walio.
Cast out demons.
Kemea mapepo.
Heal.
Ponya.
Clean.
Fungua.
Just one scripture.
Kuandiko moja tu.
And I want God to give me authority over demons.
Mungu anipe mamlaka juu ya mapepo.
Right?
Sawa?
What do I do?
Tafanya nini?
I use that scripture.
Natumia lile andiko.
I enter the dimension of the scripture.
Ingia katika ile maandiko.
And I see it coming to pass.
Na naona lile andiko likitendeka.
I'll give birth to it.
Ninaliza.
The moment what start coming,
wakati maneno itatoka,
in that silence,
katika ile kunyamaa,
you see yourself, you start moving.
Unajiona mwenyewe unaanza kusonga.
What start coming,
maneno yanakutoka.
Climbing, climbing, climbing.
Inapaa.
And then suddenly you say koto parabaka porabaka. Not in loud, in silence.
Katika kunyamaa.
You are not forcing it, it's coming easily.
Inatoka tu.
That's why you can see in the wall of prayer,
katika
in Jerusalem,
Jerusalem,
people who want to drop prayer, they always move like this. You see
sawa
that? Right?
See,
how many have seen that?
Angapi waliona
they always baba, move like this
alikuwa
with their prayer. Why?
Numaumbia.
God's power is in that place.
Bwana iko mahali pale.
And it's causing them to
inafanya wanasonga.
So the moment you get a revelation out of the scripture,
ukipata ufunuo wa maandiko,
you start moving.
Unaanza kusonga.
Moving. That means your spirit is active.
Roho yako iko sawa.
And the more you are active,
na wakati uko sawa,
the words start coming.
Maneno yanaanza kukutoka.
Let there be.
Wacha pawe.
You start declaring. Let there be. Let there be.
Wacha kuwe.
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 It's in the dimensions of quietness.
Katika hali
you create
ya kunyamaza,
not a noisy place.
Sio kelele na utumbuizaji.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So any amount,
pesa yoyote,
you desire to get in money,
unatamani upate leo,
dwells in that place.
Inakaa pale.
Any man you want to marry,
mtu yote unataka kuoa,
dwells in that realm.
Anakaa pale.
Any house you want to buy,
nyumba yote unataka kununua,
dwells in that realm.
Inakaa pale. Wow.
Any breakthrough you want to face in life,
penye wote unataka,
dwells in that place.
Unaishi pale. Katabusa.
Did you get that?
Yes, sir.
Did you understand it?
Yes, Papa. Yes.
To God be the glory.
Yes, Papa.
Stand up where you are.
Simama mahali umekaa. Celebrate Jesus for the world.